Today, 94 years ago, in 1927, the deadliest school massacre in U.S. history happened at Bath Consolidated School in Bath Township. Andrew Kehoe, a school trustee, treasurer of the school board, and a handyman for the school, planted a bomb inside the building. It went off at 8:45 that morning.
It sort of rose a few feet in the air and then pancaked down. Nobody knew what was going on, but it was heard in Lansing.
The townspeople rushed to the school.
Inside the school was just as awful can be. There was one teacher whose head was wedged between two boards. She couldn't move, you know, just hoping to be rescued. And there was a boy in front of her. You know, they were almost, you know, face to face. And the kid's eyes were open and she realized the kid was dead. Some people were identifying their children by their shoes.
Kehoe drove up to the school about 30 minutes later, detonated his truck, which was loaded with dynamite, nails, screws, and other shrapnel. The explosion killed Kehoe, Superintendent Emery Hike, and others, including an 8-year-old child. Irene Dunham saw this firsthand. Dunham was a senior in high school. Because she had stayed home with a sore throat, she was not at school that day.
She was on the at home with her mother, and they heard the explosion, and they jumped in the car and they drove into town and to see what it was about. And that's when they saw the school explosion and the carnage and all that. And she talks about seeing body parts hanging from the telephone lines and dead children and their mothers kneeling over them crying and stuff like that.
And I remember was all the little kids that were killed.
Matt Martin, co-owner of Optic Film and Digital, is in the final stages of producing a 4-part docuseries about the massacre that he has been working on for the past 16 years.
They didn't have words to describe what he had done. There weren't the domestic terrorism. There was the world's first suicide car bombing ever in the world.
The victims were 38 children and 4 adults, 6 if you include Kehoe and his wife Nellie, who was later found dead on their property. Some accounts say Kehoe blew up the building because he was upset about school taxes, that he couldn't pay the mortgage on his farm. Arnie Bernstein, author of the 2009 book Bath Massacre, says that's not quite right.
No. He blew up the school because he was a psychopath.
For more photos and information on the Bath School Massacre, go to fox47news.com. Reporting for Fox 47 News from your neighborhood in Bath Township, I'm Lauren Shields.